We are so glad to be back on stage and in person performing again, and we're glad for you guys to be our first audience of the year for TUPS, so thank you, thank you. Just wanted to let you guys know, like, these first years, these directors that have been working for the show have been working so hard since literally like the first day of school to perform this show for you, so we're really excited. Thank you so much for coming out and showing your support, and I'm really excited to show you guys all of their hard work. Before we get started, I want to give you guys just a couple announcements. First of all, please silence all cell phones so that you're not disturbing the performance. Also, this show must follow all Trinity policies regarding COVID, so all actors will be completely masked the entire time. And I also ask that you also please respect our performers and those around you by keeping your mask on at all times during the performance. If you are handed any oranges during the performance, also please refrain from eating those because that's not COVID safe. Thank you. Be advised also that several shows contain content designed for mature audiences that may not be suitable for all viewers. If you have phobias of dads, demonic cats, or cardboard cutouts of Danny Anderson,
yes,
we advise you to leave now. I promise we will not think less of you unless it is about the cardboard cutouts of Danny Anderson. That's disappointing. All right. Finally, I am also legally obligated to warn you that first years can be dangerous and unpredictable. And as such, we cannot guarantee that they will not leave the stage and attempt to interact with the audience. After years of research done on this phenomenon, we have determined that the best way to respond to this instance is to reciprocate that interaction, and hopefully, chances are, they will move on and leave you alone. All right, now, without further ado, it is my absolute pleasure to announce our first show of the evening, and here's the blurb. Imagine a world where every Trinity student was turned into their dad Sona, a baseball player turned into a t-ball coach, a sorority girl turned into a dilf. It's up to Bailey, with Chaplain Alex as her advisor, to defeat the dads with their own medicine. Dad jokes. This is the invasion of the dads.
My dad says there's
Try four.
I guess you wouldn't know. Anyways, I need a full night's sleep before our first day of new student orientation tomorrow. I'm sure it's all very vital information. Why else would it be several days long?
Good luck with that, sweetie.
Toodles.
Feels like it's 1991 again.
Wait, but we were born in 2003!
Anyways, I gotta get back to the house. Gotta get the man cave set up for the big game later. Be a pal and get me a couple six packs while you're out, okay, champ?
That's weird. I wonder why everyone is acting like they turned into a... Well, they turned into a... It's so strange. I know... Ew! What are daddy issues? relationships with their fathers have. Okay, sure. I do love my dad. But what about you?
I have a great relationship with my father.
My daddy in heaven? Besides, I'm not sure why all these people on Trinity's campus have these so-called daddy issues anyway. Don't you get it? It's up to us to save the world from the invasion of the dads! Let's go! Wait, what are we doing? Getting the hat back? I don't understand.
Up the tower, mainly.
Why are we bringing it to the Trinity Tower? I can't afford to lose my scholarship.
Okay, we must journey up the stairs in order to return the hat to its rightful place in my office.
Journey, isn't it just a bunch of stairs? We just did our tower climb. Well, we did it.
It is a bunch of stairs. However, the wearer only has power from the highest point on campus. The tower is guarded by the school's manliest, strongest, and sexiest dads.
Yeah. You ready for the big game tonight, champ?
Oh my gosh! Is it like 12 men run down the hall?
Yes, the hot tournament of the dad they were always meant to be. A T-ball dad.
What do I do? I don't want to hurt them.
You have to defeat him using your own medicine. The dad jokes.
Baseball player holds water.
The pitcher!
No, the big game!
Come on, this is easy!
Not so easy, kid! Not so easy!
You're my age, not ancient!
Maybe!
But it's just the truth!
Ha ha ha!
That looks like a barbecue, Dad.
What a gambling casino. Leave the gambling casino.
Because he was on a road!
Life climbing to the top of this wretched institution and this wretched tower to get my revenge. Trinity took my dad. They'll be coming back. They'll be giving all the dads back, and the entire world will become my dad.
I knew the Lord had reason for bestowing this ship made tower upon us.
No. Well, my hat and my dad, I'm just a sad, shriveled shell of a man.
I must take this. The love of a father is too powerful and rare to exist in a physical form.
Hey, guys, I just saw someone getting free tuition. Oh, I'll have what this guy's having. Oh,
poor daddy in heaven. It seems like Tyler is still a dilf?
Oh, no. No, guys, I'm fine. I was actually just, there was something in my throat.
No! 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 No!
So good that I thought, oh man, like this is inspiring me to make my own comedy routine. So I looked up some theater puns with that. So I'm going to read them to you guys now, and you can tell me what you think. Ready? Alright, so a friend was in a theater production about English language puns. It was a play on words. Okay, I got a couple more. Alright. Got a job as a theater lighting technician once. It was spot on. Okay, somebody was really laughing to that one. Okay, one more. Alright, opening a new shadow puppet theater. Business plan says we'll make a fortune, but those are just projected figures. Alright, okay. I'm done. I'm sorry for subjecting you to more of those. But I promise that our next show is sure to be a blast. Which is one more pun. Let me read you the blurb for the next show. A thrilling tale about revenge, friendship, and the pursuit of jazz. That's it. This is The Sting!
Alright, listen up. On a beautiful sunny day here at Trinity University, three students and one professor meet to discuss their duties as the resident Bee Club members on campus. The birds are chirping, the sky is blue, and the cockroaches on Cardiac Hill are sound asleep. But something, or shall I say someone, is not asleep. Little do they know there is something above.
Snow, it like totally blocks out sound or something. Because I was screaming and screaming for someone to get me out of this frozen hellscape, and no one got me out for like an hour.
Oh, hi, Alex. That sounds awfully cold. Well, I'm glad you escaped that predicament. If Charlie called your summer.
Oh, summer was good. I spent a lot of it outside too. I was able to be part of this big compost project with a garden organization that I joined. I saw more worms than I ever have before, and it was amazing.
I too love myself a humble worm. You do so much good for the world. How interesting that you enjoy compost, but it's such a pure piece.
Ever since I was young, I've had this recurring dream where I reach in my pocket for a piece of gum, but instead I pull out a swarm of bumblebees
guys cared or something.
Oh, Charlie, that's fucking weird. Sorry. Bizarre how you can't just put words like be and bizarre together in the same sentence next to each other. This is a learning opportunity for all of us. I've never encountered a hive like this one before. Look here.
Oh yeah, no, that does look weird.
Have you gotten to see one of the hive members yet, Dr. Perry?
Not yet. I haven't been successful in pushing anyone out so far.
Maybe if we sung, we could get some of them to come out. Personally, I'm always intrigued when I hear someone sing.
Alex, I don't think the bees want to hear you do karaoke.
No, we should just leave them alone. What if they're partying? I can't interrupt their party. Oh, no.
Charlie was right to be concerned. That dream was no dream. It was a memory. When Charlie was 3 years old, she murdered my great, great Uncle Ron, who was a jazz legend. His music brought the hive peace and comfort in our trying times. Bees wept at the sound of his groovy solos. And we have never forgotten. You know how they say, oh, an elephant never forgets. Well, a bee always remembers. For generations and generations, my family has carried that grief. Finally, the time has come for me to exact my revenge. Charlie has no idea what I have in store.
I'm gonna go with Hooked on Feeling. Now that's always, and I mean always, a fan favorite.
Well, I think that's a splendid idea, Alex. Go ahead.
Thank you.
Charlie, don't freak out.
Ah! Bees! Get away from me!
friends have to suffer just to keep the jazz alive. You don't want their blood in your wings, you pathetic sack of shit. Besides, I know you never had the lung capacity to play the sax like I could. Please, buddy, come on, give him a chance.
Uncle Ron, is that you? All these years of plotting my revenge and you haven't said a word, why now?
I didn't think you'd get this far. I mean, look, kid, I love you, I really do, but, I mean, you're not a closer, buddy, but...
Oh, man. Great-great Uncle Ron. Oh, that stings.
Hey, I don't know, man. I really thought you were going to kill us back there or something, you know?
Really?
Yeah.
I was just about ready to pee myself for great-great Uncle Ron today.
Me too.
Yeah. Well, all right. You've got a deal. If I'm being honest with myself, I'm a lover, not a fighter. Maybe it's time I stepped down from the whole revenge business and pursued my true passion. Candle making.
Oh my god, I love candles. I'll totally support your small business.
I'm so pleased that this conflict has been de-escalated. I am curious, however, how to return back to humans and do a process therapy.
All you have to do is, watch this, close your eyes, rub your antenna together, and say three times in unison, there's no place like home. Yeah.
Alright.
There's no place like home.
And kids. That's the story of how I met your mother. Have a great night.
Here is the description. Jealousy is in the air at Trinity University. Our very own Danny Anderson aims to have his name written in the stars with the likes of Jeff Bezos and Richard Branson. But how will he get there? Surely not using the Trinity Tower as a rocket, right? This is Danny Anderson's half-baked journey to space!
Excited to be
be on campus for the first time?
You bet. Although it sucks we still have to wear masks even though we're vaccinated. Still better than high school, though.
Xander! Ben!
Good to see you again, Platypus.
I'm told not to call me that.
Sorry, Harry.
It's all right. Check this out. Jeff Bezos went into space.
This article was written a month ago.
Yeah, we've all known about that.
Quit taking the wind out of my sails.
Although it is a trend for billionaires to go to space. Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, Sir Richard Branson.
But who cares? The highest we'll ever get up is Trinity Tower. It's time to go climb it anyway. Hey, what's that?
Huh. I guess that's the tower. And those look like state-of-the-art rocket engines.
Have those always been there?
I've been on on-campus tour, and I certainly have never seen them.
Wait a minute. You guys know there's construction going on campus this year, right?
Yeah, they're building a new place for the English department.
Have you seen the construction?
No.
None of us live in San Antonio. There's no way we could have seen it.
Then the story about the English department building must be a cover. And someone's planning on taking Richardson Tower to space.
Hello, welcome to Trinity. Climbing up a 180-foot tower seems a lot easier in concept.
At least we get a break from the sun.
You bet. Your boots. I'll be guzzling a bunch of those little paper cones of water when we get to...
Oh, that's great.
Where's Dr. Anderson?
Oh! Hello! Welcome to Trinity. What's your name?
Ben.
Ben. Your last name?
I don't have one.
Well, this is Ben, no last name. I've actually been waiting for you. You see, there's something I want to ask you.
What is that?
You may not have noticed, but there's something very special about this tower. There's
state-of-the-art rocket engine stuck to the side of it.
Why, yes! Strangely enough, nobody else has noticed them. That means that everything is going according to plan. You see, I'm planning on using this tower as a rocket to take myself 351,211 feet into space! So, I hear you're planning on majoring in astrology, Mr. No Last Ben Name.
Actually, it's,
Excellent! It just happens to be one more space on the rocket. And I'd like to give it to you so you can experience my 15-minute journey to space!
Come on, what? Ben, you gotta take us with you!
Yeah, this tower is huge! Why can't we all come?
Yeah, Dr. Anderson, why can't my friends come with?
Well, there's been some stability issues. Fine. But now they have to settle. Oh, wow! It's not every day you're gonna spend 15 minutes in the vacuum of space!
I'm gonna love space. This'll be the trip of a lifetime.
I guess I'll take you up on your offer.
I knew you'd say that!
Something doesn't feel quite right, though.
You have nothing to worry about, Mr. Ben Name. Trust me. The launch is planned for 24 hours from now. Have until then to get your spacesuits. Oh. Now, we should get going. There must be quite the backup of students. Let's get our picture and then be on our way. Say cheese!
My calculations are correct. I knew it.
There you are, Benji.
We were wondering where you were. We haven't seen you since the tower.
I've been doing some calculations. Look at this. When Dr. Anderson said that he's taking Richardson Tower to space, that it wasn't only a stupid idea, but a dangerous one. I mean, Richardson Tower is right in the middle of upper campus. And you guys have seen how big a blast it is from a rocket, right?
Yeah.
Of course.
Well, if my simulation's correct, if Danny Anderson goes through with this plan, half the Trinity could be destroyed.
Wait, does that include Mars McLean?
Yeah, Perry, Mars McLean would be destroyed first.
Great, because I am hating my calculus class. And the building get destroyed by a rocket blast seems way easier than dropping it.
What about maybe?
Unfortunately, maybe safe.
What about Calvert? There was this dude from Calvert at Olympics.
Can we get back to the matter at hand? If we don't do something, half of Trinity is destroyed.
Okay.
Why us?
Because we've been chosen to go with Dr. Anderson. It has plan.
Oh, boy. Well, then, it's been 18 hours. Where's your plan?
Keep your shirt, Perry. I've got a plan. I was able to convince Dr. Anderson's assistant to give us a rocket, to give us the schematics of the rocket.
Here you go.
Thank you, Megan. Here. Look at this. This is where we'll be sitting, in the cockpit, next to Dr. Anderson. Dr. Anderson will be sitting right here. Above him are four switches, each connected to one of the state-of-the-art rocket engines. And we have to turn off the switches in order to stop the rocket from launching.
So, we have to flip one of these switches in order to prevent the rocket from launching?
Actually, we have to flip all four of the switches. If we only flip one of the switches, only one of the engines will turn off, the rocket will flip over on its side, and the whole thing will blow up, causing more damage.
But the switches are over Dr. Anderson's seat. Can't we just turn them back on?
That's why one of us has to distract him, while the other one will turn off the switches.
That could work.
Why not just talk to him and tell him his idea is terrible?
Because Dr. Anderson will be hearing about...
Hey, spaceman, turn it up to the stars!
Now,
are you ready for your lives to change?
Sure.
Great! Then off we go!
Dr. Anderson.
Are you sure this plan is a good idea?
Of course I am, my boy. Why do you ask?
Well, I've done some calculations, and if my simulation's correct, it could destroy half of Trinity.
Oh, well, that's a shame.
You mean you don't care?
One half of a campus is a small price to pay for the adventure of a lifetime. After all, anything is possible with the power of hubris. Now, let's take our seats.
So who's going to do the distraction?
You volunteer. You do the distraction.
Then who's going to flip the switches?
I'll do it. Don't worry about it.
What are y'all talking about, kids?
Oh, nothing, sir.
Space Alexa, start the countdown!
Initiating launch sequence in T-minus 60 seconds. 59,
58, 57. So, Dr. Anderson, do you have any music prepared for the flight?
Not at the moment, but I'm open to suggestions.
Well, I was thinking something quiet and contemplative, like the Atlantis music from Blubber.
Ah, that's that childish Gambino you kids are listening to.
That's Donald Blubber. Blubber on its own is a video game for the Nintendo 64, and the soundtrack, with all due respect, slaps. I need to add to our space playlist.
I will definitely consider it.
Oh, and the Atlantis music from Banjo-Tooie. The Atlantis music in video games is just amazing.
I really don't know what that is, my child, but thank you!
Well, you should really just, you know...
Can I tell the Nintendo 64?
We're running out of time!
No, I already flipped those switches!
You did?
You mean you didn't notice?
2, 1, 0.
Blubber. Ah! 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 then. Oh. Ah, Megan! Tell me, what's the status of campus right now?
No important buildings were destroyed by the blaster.
Oh, does that mean Mars McLean is still up? Why are you sad? I like calculus.
Nerd. Yes, I'm now officially an astronaut!
No, you're not.
You're just some university president who went to space once. So, does that mean that you actually did consider the destruction of campus?
Of course I did. If campus gets destroyed, that's going on my resume. That's why I left Megan behind in charge to assess the damages so that I could cover anything up. Fortunately, there was none.
Then my calculations were wrong.
That's a relief. Let's go get a snack at Maybe. I'm afraid you can't do that. Through some miracle, Maybe Dining Hall spontaneously combusted at the exact moment of the launch.
What? Maybe it's the furthest building from campus. It shouldn't have been touched.
I don't know what to tell you.
I guess we have to go somewhere else.
What about Revolve? The Revolve it is.
Oh boy! I can't wait to tell Bezos about this! He's gonna be so jealous.
A billionaire jealous of a university president? Somehow,
I doubt that.
Oh, you.
All right. Just cleaning real quick. Excuse me. All right, you know what? I will read the next blurb while sweeping. Alright, next show we have, in a land long terrorized by the Dark One, three adventurers go on a quest to take them down. Our intrepid heroes, Sir James, Dylan, and Kate, have located an artifact that will lead them into the lair of the Dark One. Will they be successful in securing it? Will they be able to take down the Dark One? Find out in Killing the Cliche.
Thin pool, tell.
What
such abilities do you possess?
I can do this.
Okay. Yes. Very impressive. Lights from nowhere when we are trying to be stealthy! I should have clarified because, as I recall, you're not the one who has been keeping us fed over the last several weeks.
You killed two rabbits, and then you still made me clean, butcher, and cook them.
Mm-hmm.
I've been doing the foraging and the feeding.
Lady Lovegeast, you do all the women's work with such grace and poise. None would dare suggest otherwise.
Still not my name.
My lady. I give you all due respect for the work that you do, but right now, I seem to have larger concerns. Such as the fact that you, Sirrah, do not qualify for the cliche of magical powers, because you can make thin lights. Shut up! They're not fairy lights, they're points of electromagnetic radiation, and they're totally gonna help me defeat the Dark One.
Absurd!
Cliche! How will this trip help with any such endeavors? Nonsense, my friend. I cannot fathom a method. What will you do? Shine a light in their eyes until they go away?
Obviously, I'll either come into the full scope of my powers later, or they'll be useful in some more innovative way.
Can we keep walking? Or are you two just gonna stand here and argue?
Not now, Lady Lovegeast.
Oh my god, I'm finding the artifact myself.
You have no training for your powers.
I don't need training.
How do you expect to defeat the scourge on our land that is the Dark One? Without any idea of how to use your abilities, all the more reason why I'm the hero. Really, verily, what the fuck does that even mean? I have trained under the greatest masters in the land in sword fighting and the like. I have won turns, claimed victories, rescued the ladies and beaten back creatures of the dark. I am the one with the most cliches. Clearly, I'm the one of which the prophecy speaks.
Dude, you gotta get with the times. No one cares about those anymore. It's all about underdogs and orphans growing up to be more than anyone ever thought they could be. If anything, you're destined to be a bully who gets defeated in the second act when our intrepid young hero learns to overcome his doubters. I mean, who needs training when I have this?
Look! No one will actually be able to sneak onto the grounds of... Oh my god, Dylan! Tell me you aren't showing off your birthmark again!
It's not a birthmark!
You're to do it every time?
It's a magic mark that the Dark One gave me when they slaughtered my parents. It's what marks me as the cliche hero of prophecy.
You have literally always had that.
Right, because we grew up in the same orphanage love interest. If I got it when I was orphan, you would have always have seen me with it.
Yeah, which means that you know my name is Kate.
That's another thing. We grew up together. Gives us the obvious best friends to lovers arc. I mean, clearly she's the love interest. I'm the hero. And you're the best friend slash sidekick.
There's no way you've been this stupid the entire time I've known you, is there?
Sir James, right hand and sword of the House of Oak is sidekick tonight! If anything, the lady is my mistress by virtue of meeting at a time in our lives that much engender fraternal feelings, and you, Sirrah, are the scrappy youngster who learns from me despite never managing to be a proper squad.
The lady can speak for herself and still has no interest in either of you!
Of course, Lady Love. I mean to cast no doubt on your ability to choose a suitor. No knight of honor would ever pursue her unwanted.
Look, genius, just because I no longer think you're here to sell us out does not mean that you have some kind of right to me.
Never, milady.
I'm not willing to put in the effort necessary to have this argument right now. Can we go to the Dark One's lair?
Oh, I've got this. Let me get this straight. You hired a minstrel.
Yes.
For montage music.
Of course.
That's such bullshit. Who does that?
But you can see how it could be employed to quick a montage from my years of training.
Get a damn phone, dude. There's so much music on the internet.
I feel like you do not thoroughly understand them. The types of cliches to which my successes are attributed.
I'm just saying, modern fantasy is totally a thing, and with a lot less effort.
Is that the landmark this thing is talking about?
Milady, I would be happy to assist you, should you require it.
James! Last time you navigated, we lost 8 weeks worth of progress in 2 days. I don't even know how you found that portal.
Like many heroes of you, I have no sense of direction.
Yeah.
Useless cliche.
Oh, but you admit it is one, young villain.
Barely. What does it even qualify?
It leads me on fantastic quests. Why? I should have never found the blaze of Akatiri if I had not been lost in the forest of the night.
Wait, that's the blade of Akatiri?
Finally, you see my cliche.
Why the hell didn't you lead with that?
Why do either of you care, anyways?
Everyone knows that whoever's the most cliches is clearly the one destined to defeat the Dark One.
Uh-huh.
Which, for the record, is still totally me.
Uh-huh.
I'll look around. The Dark One murdered my parents!
Oh, boo! The Dark One slaughtered dozens, hundreds. You are not the first, nor the last.
What makes you so special? No. The Dark One personally sought out and murdered my parents, deliberately and in particular, for the work my parents did against them.
Oh, it's the door!
That is indeed a tragedy.
And it's locked.
See?
Do either of you give a damn, or...
However, that is a good point!
And I don't even know why I asked.
I, too, have lost much to the Dark One.
Oh, bullshit! You told your tragic origin story, haven't... way before the Dark One rose to power.
You speak truly, young woman. But I cannot say the same for the loss of my mentor.
Didn't you have, many masters and all of the arts or something?
Yes, of course. But this one was the wisest and the truest of all. Like a father to me, he was.
Guys! Guys!
More wise than any other.
Guys!
Yes, well, not now, baby.
My name is Kate.
What is it?
The door is open. Do you want to go in and defeat the Dark One, or are you just gonna stand here?
Of course! Onwards! I shall tell you of my mentor on the way!
Murder, but still means that we take the higher road of compassion for the sake of what could have been.
Compassion? I have compassion for the victims they have created. Clearly you are too naive. All the more reason you are the psychic.
Do they not intend to fight me?
They probably do. They just gotta work around, you know.
No, James. Certainly. You're right.
You've got it backwards. You're cynical and jaded. I'm the idealistic young hero that proves we can do it this way. Without calling anyone names, what's next? A slur?
Did these imbeciles do any of the work in penetrating my castle?
If anything, being foul-mouthed is your cliche.
Not really.
You think I'd call someone a slur?
Yeah.
I see. Have you any desire to work for me?
Do you want me to work for you?
I respect competency.
No thanks.
I have a moral code. Shame. But understandable.
Yeah.
I may be rude.
I'm not a terrible person. I'm the hero of this story.
I'm the hero of this story. Oh, yeah. That's totally why you insist on calling me Sarah, emphasizing that you don't respect me. Oh, yeah. I do know what that means. I read Shakespeare as an escape from those who didn't care about me growing up. I have culture and soft undersides.
Then you understand that those terms are a matter of propriety.
Do it!
Well, they argue. What do you like to find me? Well, I guess I've done literally everything else.
But, Trinity, now it's time for you to stand aside. And let me defeat the dark. Now it's time for you to stand aside and let me defeat the dark one. How, with your fairy light,
at a point of electromagnetic radiation,
let someone who actually knows how to fight do so. Will you get over your damn training? Like, what good does it do you anyway?
But, well, it gives me reward.
Well, here. You just carry that around with you. This is a broken baseball trophy.
In appearance, yes, but it was won as a prize in a sword fighting tournament in the land of Fae.
You won a broken baseball trophy in a sword fighting tournament?
Its true form can only be seen in the land of the Faerful.
You realize how stupid that sounds, right?
Cliche, perhaps?
You know what? How about this? We both fight the dark one. Whoever deals the final blow is the hero, and whoever doesn't, the sniper. Fair?
A truly decisive test.
Let's do this! You're the hero of the story?
Is it misogyny? Is that why you're like this?
I swore you were the love interest.
Compulsive heteronormativity, need to be macho, come on.
What cliches does she even have? Kate did grow up in the same orphanage as me.
Oh! Now you remember my name.
I guess that means...
That means that...
What was the love interest?
For the last time! I'm a lesbian, come on! What's that even? No!
I totally saw that childhood best friend status, which means that...
Come on!
I can be the sidekick!
Oh no, you don't!
So get hyped, get excited, and here's the blurb. Get ready for some heisting. And this Fypot, we watch D tell his grandson the story of how he got his cat. Read this next part very suave in James Bond voice. Oh. D's story transpired while he was a student at Trinity. He and his friends were forced to pull off a heist that was so unnecessarily convoluted in order to stop a deranged mascot from summoning demons to destroy Trinity University. This is the secret mission to stop demons from invading Trinity University through a heist. Let's go!
Oh, Jesus.
another icebreaker. Oh, it's Steven! Did you hear that? We should maybe get the hell out of here before we draw any unwanted attention.
Roar!
Hey, would you shut the fuck up?
University as a mascot, metaphorically of course for you, but actually for me! We shall have our revenge soon! Evil!
Evil!
Woo! Danger, danger!
Shut this thing up! You're gonna get us killed!
Good job, D.
You could have just asked politely. All my calculations tell me you're 100% bitch.
Ladies, ladies, now is not the time for your womanly squabbling.
Misogyny detected. Combinations being made to protect these fragile male ego. You are so right.
I know.
Feed me more of your smart male brain info into my dumb female robot brain.
Thank you, I think. Anyways, they are going to summon demons. Trying to stop this could be dangerous.
We could be silent.
Yeah, I'm in. It would be a huge bummer if hell on earth happened before I got to meet
Cher. Oh my goodness, we need to make a plan. We need to assemble a team. We need to gather information. I have already begun assembling a digital conspiracy board.
Oh my god, that's so fucking hot.
But first, let's get the fuck out of here.
Thank you.
my girlfriend and conspiracy bot, Amy! Say hello, Amy!
I thought we agreed the sex bot would stay in the dorm.
Oh. She didn't agree to that agreement.
Hello, I'm Amy, standing for Artificial Mystery U. And we are here to present to you the newest orientation activity. We're putting on a special show.
Ta-da! Yes, this orientation activity is a very special one. It will be a great way to engage with the community and connect with your peers.
We are looking for some dedicated individuals looking to help us out with a special mission. Show. A special show. The name of this show is The Secret Mission to Stop Trinity University from Being Invaded by Demons Through a Heist.
Yes, my research indicates that humans are influenced by music, so I compiled this song to manipulate you into joining. It's called Only Boring Virgins Stay at Home Instead of Joining Theater, Then Die Alone.
Only boring virgins!
Hey! Sorry, and Kate?
That's an excellent question, not quite. We did spend the entire budget on this banner!
That sucks! Boo!
Well, it sure got you something, didn't it, Daddy?
Or should I say, someone?
He looks like all of Cher's backup dancers, homosexual and scantily clad. I'm really into this.
You bet your buns you are. Everybody needs some Patrick. Cut the music, Taylor. Cut the music, Taylor. I appreciate the fanfare, but it's no longer necessary. No. Silly girl. You mess with the techie's light board once, and then she's all over ya.
Can we help you?
No, sweet boy. It is I who is going to help you.
He thought the baby talk would kill it.
This humanoid is factually enticing to all.
He could be useful. For the mission.
Do we not?
Well, I do self-identify as a femme fatale. Femme boy fatale, that is.
Look, we were looking for someone with a bit more muscle, you know, to counteract my brains.
Oh, I can handle anyone that comes our way. Besides, you're trying to be sneaky, right? He can help with his...
I can be quite persuasive. But I need to be.
Alright, look. We're looking to see if there are any demon rituals occurring on campus. You know, for our show. For our show. Want to be accurate, of course.
Yeah, you mean the one that's happening in the theater building, like, tomorrow?
See? Told you he'd be useful.
Can we keep him? Can we keep
yes.
him?
Yay! I helped. I mean, technically it is in my only butt. If you show enough ass, believe it, you can get it anywhere.
Fine! Just keep your ass cleavage yourself.
Yay!
From Amy, the first trap will be a laser maze. Now, I'm wasn't sure if it's the type that sets off an alarm or cuts you in half, so proceed with caution. I, as the fearless leader, will go first. Now this is so precise that it'll require two people. Now, will you dance with me?
I thought you would never ask.
I don't think Trinity Theater has the budget for a laser maze.
Just let the people have me.
I hope you're watching carefully, because you will need to replicate my movements exactly! I will go ahead and follow through once you're done. If you die, or are otherwise maimed, please attempt to do so quietly as to not sabotage the mission. Oh, silly little Cher. Demons aren't real, neither is magic.
kind of conversation elsewhere. That's okay. Gave me enough time to finish my incantation.
Let us go!
Oh, what was that? Magic? Nothing real? Oh? What is it? Close it right now, holding you down in place.
This could be explained by a million things.
It's a gum. I hate when that happens.
Explain all you want, but the answer's clear. It's my dark magic. If that's not enough for you, let me show you something a little bit more poultry.
Chiquitas, poquitas!
Summoning ritual of that magnitude requires vessels for the demons to inhabit. could summon demons, but only the weakest ones. The ones of sloth and gluttony. All I wanted to do was eat, sleep, and then eat again. Kind of anticlimactic, if you ask me.
So, what happened to everyone else?
You didn't recognize your Uncle Pat and your Aunt Cheryl? Stupid one you got here, he just like his grandpa.
I love when you tell that story. I'm so sexy in it. The good old days.
Oh, you still got it, baby.
Oh, yeah.
The demons quickly got annoyed with Leroy's attempts to get them to do well. Anything at all, really. And they turned him into the bronze tiger statue in front of the athletic center.
I started going by Cheryl, Cheryl Tynes, quickly became the dean of the university through a mixture of extortion, intimidation, you know, girl boss shit.
I started the Trinity Cat Alliance. We have a whole system of blood oaths going. Once you're in the cat feeding business, you never get out.
And what about Amy?
Well, you see, the demons all each offered us one thing to hide their existence.
For Cher to live forever.
For Leroy to give peace.
And for my dear, sweet, beautiful Amy to become human. A year after everything went down, we got married!
What?
Sweetheart, would you like some cookies?
Oh, get over here, you sexy former bucket of bolts.
This is crazy!
And yet, all true!
October, so Halloween weekend, so please be there for that, and that'll be in the courtyard, you guys can't miss it. All right, guys, have a great night. Thank you for coming again.